Well, Rintaro, what can we say about you? You were 5 foot tall, 10 inches wide, and you liked extraterrestrial lights, and you disliked cars for some reason. Were you the ultimate racist? Who knows? But the only thing that we do know for sure, fam, you did. Yep. Bad end. My class trial, our class trial, deadly life. It starts.
Rintaro?
What in the world? What the hell's going on?
Rapture at Tenko screamed. The front door of the library burst open, and the four people who were in the game room rushed in.
What happened?
Gunta here scream! Oh! Blood! So much blood!
Oh me, oh my!
Isn't that Rintaro? What's wrong with him?
You don't know?
He's dead.
Huh?
What? He's dead? Well, that's unfortunate.
But how?
How can you be so calm? Suichi examined Rintaro's body and placed his hand close to his mouth to check for breathing.
It's no use.
We're too late. He shook his head.
No way.
Too late? You mean dead?
Are you serious?
He's dead? My vision began to swirl. My legs wobbled beneath me. But out of sheer desperation, I kept my mind working. Why was Rintaro here? And the monitor is off. It's no longer displaying Monokuma anymore. Does that mean the mastermind is dead? Yeah, that has to be it. This means Rintaro was...
Well...
This means the killing game has started, yeah?
Huh?
What?
What?
Killing game? Then someone killed Rintaro in... Wait, maybe not.
I don't get it.
What do you mean, maybe not? Maybe the killing game hasn't started. Maybe this just ended it.
What?
Ended it? What do you mean?
Because...
The mastermind! The mastermind. Rintaro was the mastermind.
Huh?
What? The mastermind? I don't know how he died, but if Rintaro was in the library before the time limit ended...
That's true.
There's a high chance that the mastermind planned this. And if he's dead...
Huh?
What?
A body has been discovered! Everyone, please gather in the library!
Oh, what a relief. A murder took place just before time ran out.
Huh?
Monokuma? But how? I gotta admit, I was a little nervous there, because the killing game hadn't started yet. Jeez, you guys really know how to keep me in suspense. How? The mastermind controlling you is...
Huh?
My mastermind? Damn, the real mastermind is controlling me? And you think it was Rintaro? What an imagination! Of course that's wrong! If the mastermind had died, this killing game would be over.
That's wrong!
But...
Hey,
The victim was Rintaro, a mummy. The ultimate, who cares? Nothing more, nothing less.
Huh?
What are you talking about? Suichi, what does he mean? It's going to happen.
No.
Hey, Monokuma. Is wrong, isn't he? Isn't Rintaro the mastermind?
Huh?
Yeah, We came here as soon as the sensor went off, right? No one else was in the library. Rintaro was the only one who could have moved the bookcase. Wouldn't that mean he was trying to use that hidden door? And that he was the mastermind?
No.
But if he was the mastermind, why is the killing game not over? Why is he dead?
It's no use.
It's no good. I don't know. Suiji? The pictures. We can check the pictures. I'm sure the cameras we set up in the library will give us a clue. At the moment, the library door swung wide open. And everybody else is here.
Oh no!
Rintaro, but why?
Really?
That's Rintaro? Oh, thank God. I thought that was a pile of dirty rags.
I see.
So this ended up happening after all. My. What the world this is, so full of jokes like this.
How?
What? This is a lie, right? My dearest Rintaro is... was killed?
Stop it.
That's the same thing. Ironic. The guy who wanted to live ended up dead. The guy who wanted to die survived.
Either way.
So, can somebody explain the meaning of all this? An explanation isn't necessary. Thanks to the first blood perk, there won't be a class trial. So that'd just be a waste of time.
Go ahead!
With that said, if you're the blacken who killed Rintaro, raise your hand!
What?
The one who killed Rintaro?
Degenerate male!
I knew it! A degenerate male killed Rintaro, didn't he?
Wait!
How do you know Boy did it?
I won't forgive you!
I know, okay? Violent crimes are almost always committed by violent, disgusting men.
Damn.
That dumbass. How dare he go and get himself killed?
Don't screw around!
Who all did it? I'll freaking punch you into orbit! Don't get so angry. Send off your graduating classmate with warm farewells.
Rise and shine, sign.
Oh, dang.
It's getting interesting.
Or send them off with hostility like a bunch of catty poppy girls. That's fine, too.
It's my time to shine.
But if I'm going to disrupt the process, then we're going to bust out the XLs.
Kokori.
No, I'm not going to. I'm going to look. I don't want to look at a nasty little body. Nothing beats crashing a funeral. It's way better than wedding crashing. Oh my god, there's a whole entire thing about funeral crashing with wedding crashes. Oh god. I'll throw in a wedding every now and then. But funerals are insane. Like fishing with dynamite.
So
whoever did this really gets to graduate, huh?
Yeah.
Heck yeah. I'm a real sticker for the rules. I'm also tough on convenience store clerks.
My heart's racing.
And congratulations, would the blacken who's about to graduate please raise their hand? On the threshold of an amazing
adventure. What?
What the? And no one's raising their hand?
You bastards!
Hey, didn't you hear me? All the blacken has to do with graduate is speak up, you know?
Eh?
No one's stepping forward? What's going on? I see how it is. The Blacken has no need for the first blood perk. They would rather do a class trial. Excuse me?
Oh.
Very well then.
Psycho!
I will give the Blacken what they want and hold a class trial.
Oh.
Wow.
It's getting interesting.
Now this is a spicy twist.
Hold on.
Well, wait, what the heck's going on?
Got it.
Like you said before, we're gonna hold a class trial so you bastards can find Rintaro's killer.
So?
Yeah, get it right and only the blacken will be punished. But you get it wrong. what is this? A simultaneous surgery, brain and knee, then brain surgery again.
My heart's racing.
Everyone besides the blacken will be punished. Everyone besides the blacken? Everyone? This outcome is so much worse. The culprit should have stepped forward.
Thrills, chills, kills.
But before we go to hold the class trial, you gotta investigate first. If you don't investigate the murder, you won't be able to argue over who did it.
Jeez.
So you're saying we need to do the investigation ourselves, too?
Hmm?
Of course. The investigation is what makes the killing game so good. You guys are going to investigate this crime and uncover the truth. The Blackens' handiwork has made this much more entertaining than I expected. Alright, the trial will begin soon, so please give the investigation your all.
So long, farewell!
Well then, I'll bid us goodbye to Rantaro.
Alright!
Let's get going then!
Wait!
Where are we going?
Don't you get it?
We're going to look for the truth of Rantaro's death, right? We can't figure out who the culprit is. Then we'll be annihilated for sure.
Huh?
I don't want to be annihilated. The girls should be allowed to live at least. I'm just a cute, normal girl. Could use magic, you know?
Why, you?
You're the last person who should be calling herself cute.
Ben.
Do not fret. Just imagine this is something out of a police drama or a detective manga.
Do you agree?
Right, Tsuhiji?
Okay.
Right.
Impossible!
I'm in trouble. I never watched police dramas or read detective manga.
Let's see.
Well, there's no need to think so hard. We need only converse with the corpse. A corpse is not simply a dead person. This is just an assumption made by the living.
Wonderful.
Yes, by coming face to face with the corpse, you will learn a great many things. Why are you getting excited? You're not into dead bodies, are you?
Actually.
But is it true? Is one of us really the culprit? The odds are 1 in 15. That shouldn't be hard to figure out.
Don't screw around!
I mean, the odds are actually 1 in 16. Rantaro could kill himself. That's the problem here!
On your knees!
Who's the fucking culprit, huh? Is it you? Or maybe it's you? Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Who's the killer? Only Atua knows.
Weird.
You know can choose that way.
How exciting.
Everyone's competing to see who's the most paranoid. Yeah, that's not boring.
That's wrong.
Wait, stop. We can't do this. We can't go back and forth accusing each other. For now, we need to trust each other and start a serious investigation.
Huh?
Hey.
If we lose our trust in one another, because of this, it's all over. We have to believe in each other and investigate this case.
Huh?
Investigating it is the same thing as not trusting each other?
No.
No, it's completely different from what Monokuma wants us to do. He wants us to throw accusations at one another, lose all trust in each other.
But
we can't let him get what he wants. We need to investigate this murder. Not because we don't trust each other, but because we do. Did I say something wrong? You were just so directive and assertive. No, I just said what was on my mind.
Yeah.
You really are a detective. Now that we need to investigate, you're becoming super reliable.
All right.
I agree with Tsuhiji. Actually, he just said exactly what I was going to say. Males are degenerate creatures who betray others easy. But I'll trust you this time. The only good thing about males is that girls give birth to them.
When
you say it that way. Gunta not smart. Not sure Gunta be much help. But Gunta do his best for everyone.
I
will work hard with Atua's guidance. I'm much happier alive than dead anyway.
That's right.
As novice investigators, the logic indicates that we work together rather than give in to paranoia.
I will do my best.
This is what everyone desires. Then I shall give this task my all.
Okay.
You can leave it to me, and I'll find the culprit in no time. Yeah, that was a lie. Phew. I'm glad no one's given up yet. Yeah. Of course they haven't. I can't change what has already happened. All I could do is what must be done. Otherwise, Rantaro died for nothing. I have to do it. I won't give up. Well, I'll escape from here. I'll make sure of it.
Well then.
So let's get started.
I guess.
We need to do this, so poor Rantaro won't have any regrets, and so we could survive.
Okay.
Yes, let's find the culprit who killed Rantaro.
Yeah.
You're right, let's do it. Thank you, Tsuhiji. So much has happened in such a short time, I haven't been able to keep up with everything. But I know that I need to fight back against this. Class trial to protect everyone. isn't quite the mood I was expecting, but...
It's okay.
At least now you guys seem like you're getting into it. You again? The fuck are you doing here? Don't be so crude. I come to bring you all a wonderful present. This is giving me the heebie-jeebies. A notebook that will kill anyone whose name is written in it. Could it be the death note? Oops, my bad. It's a Monokuma file.
I guess.
You did that on purpose, didn't you?
Let me explain.
The Monokuma file is a detailed report that summarizes all the info about the dead. But there's no info that would point to the blackened, because that would ruin the trial.
Let's all get along.
I don't know. Maybe you guys will find it useful since you're not experts. As expert investigators, you know? I guess so.
Don't screw around.
Monokuma file. Like hell I'm gonna believe something like that.
No.
Whether you believe it or not, it would still be pertinent to examine its contents, no?
Patua has spoken.
He says we shouldn't take our eyes off the Monokuma pad. Yeah, I think we should read it. This file has the info about the victim. I wonder what it says. The victim is Rintaro Omami. It doesn't say what his ultimate talent is. The victim's body was discovered in the library. The estimated time of death is 9:10 p.m. The victim was subjected to blunt force trauma to the back of the skull, resulting in cranial fractures and immediately death. No other injuries were detected. Doesn't say whether or not he's the mastermind. Well, that's obvious. But the killing game is still going on, so I'm gonna assume he wasn't, right? But what if Rintaro wasn't the mastermind? Then who is?
Actually,
I know it's a little late, but seeing this makes it real. Rintaro is really dead.
That's right.
This is the mastermind's fault.
No doubt about it.
Mastermind killed Rintaro.
That's...
Mastermind, I'm sorry. What are we talking about?
Please.
Kaede, please explain what's going on. And spare us no detail.
Yeah.
I will. Tsuichi and I explained to everyone. We told them about the possibility of a mastermind hiding among us. And about the trap we had set in the library to lure them out. And then someone snagged in our trap. So we came to the library to check. And discover Antaro's body.
Understood.
I see. So this is what happened. I was not aware you two had planned such a thing. And so you used those cameras I modified for this bullshit?
But you know.
But why would you keep something so important a secret from us? Once we knew one of us was a mastermind, we'd start fighting over who was. That's what you two were afraid of, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
But...
If there are cameras, won't this case be solved really easy? Aw, man, that's so boring.
Wait!
Your amusement is the least of our concerns. We need to check the cameras right now. The culprit should be in the pictures. It'll be case closed.
Then...
Alright, let me go get the cameras. Tsuichi quickly retrieved all three cameras and rushed back to everyone.
Is that alright?
Okay, I got them.
Well...
It was hard removing the camera that Kaede set up. She really taped it down well.
Because...
Well, I didn't want the camera to fall since it was aimed at the moving bookcase.
Remember.
Here, it's these three cameras. Now we just have to develop the film.
I will do it.
Allow me to perform that task.
That's amazing!
Wow, is there anything the Ultimate Mate can't do?
Leave it to me!
I heard everything you said. If that's what you need, just leave it to me.
Huh? I'll do it.
I'll develop the photos so you bastards can focus on the investigation. Because if you guys get punished, you'll be way too gory.
Stop it.
Hey, don't butt into our... But she ignored my objection and walked up to Tsuichi and took the cameras from him. I am a strong, sensible woman. Do not underestimate me. Hey, give those back.
Leave it to me.
No need to worry. Yeah, I'll have to follow the rules. We won't do anything underhand or devious. So I'll let you know when I'm finished developing the photos. Hey, Ouija Power, how you doing? And yes, you kind of are, but not by much, because we're still investigating this whole entire thing. But yes, we are on chapter 1 on Deadly Life. If you know what that is, that means that someone has already died. So if you're trying to go in V3 spoiler free, just that's all I'm saying. Wait, give the cameras back! It was pointless to yell at her. Monofi left as swiftly as the wind.
Oh my!
There she goes. No, that was important evidence.
Sorry.
I was being careless.
It
probably okay. She says she developed photos, didn't give photos back.
That's right.
And she said she had to follow the rules, so I don't think she would destroy evidence.
Sheesh.
Looks like we got no choice but to believe that.
Because Atua is watching over us.
It's important to believe. Atua only shows mercy to those who believe. Kaede, I know you're worried, but you can trust me. We just have to be patient.
No.
That's not all I'm worried about. I thought this whole thing would be over once we exposed the mastermind. But now, we're just in a bigger mess. A mess we have to see through to the end.
Hey!
Kaede? I have a proposal for you.
Is that alright?
If it's alright with you, can you keep working can we keep working together during the trial? Like we're doing right now?
Huh?
Tsuichi? I know I'm just an apprentice, but I think I could help you as a detective. No, I want to help you.
Tsuichi?
Of course. With you at my side, it'll be like having 100 people helping me.
Thank you.
Kaede?
Hey,
so I don't care about this mushy stuff, so let's just get started already. But try to take this serious, okay? Our lives are on the line.
Actually,
it takes a lot of mental power to say something like that so cheerfully.
What do you think?
Before we start, I'd like to suggest that we not investigate by ourselves.
Why? In other words,
if we let the culprit walk by themselves, they might try and destroy evidence, right? Huh, you're right, since the culprit is one of us. If each of us watches the other, no one will be able to hide evidence.
My apologies.
I do not intend to offer a suggestion that would further arouse suspicion, but...
Logical.
Now, please speak your mind, Kirumi.
That's right.
It's not something you would be proud to say, and I guess we don't have a choice. After all, if we don't find out who the culprit is, we'll all be dead. Yeah, we have to do it. Once we expose the mastermind, we'll be able to escape. We can definitely do it. Okay, now we're on the investigation starting phase, finally. God dang. By the way, I'm pretty sure this fool did it. I mean, it feels super obvious that he did it. So, yeah. Like, legit. I'm just gonna put that out right now. Because he's not the victim. He has to be the murderer. He, look at his thing. I just know. Well, if you're the ultimate detective, then you got your eyes on the culprit, right?
Huh?
What?
I'll leave it to you.
Tell me who you think the culprit is. I don't mind if it's just an educated guess. Oh, I want to know too.
Sorry.
I can't say anything yet.
Not cool.
But there's someone you're a little bit suspicious of, right? Nah, there's gotta be.
Huh?
Jeez.
But you're afraid of that. You're afraid of suspecting someone. Aren't you? That's how it looks to me.
But...
with things the way they are, wouldn't it be better for you to suspect others more? And let me just warn you. The way the world works is that those who speak win. The truth can easily be twisted. In order to fix a twisted truth, you need something even more powerful.
Huh?
What do you mean?
Be careful.
I mean the testimonies without evidence are powerless. Be careful. But he's the one that did it. He done Darley did the thing. Okay, first things first. Vent. The vent is open. I was the one who took off the grant and left it in the duck. We are keeping watch in the classroom this vent leads to. Not only the culprit came in or out through there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Nah, he did. Okay, library vent. Yeah, it's already a focus, so yeah. The moving ladder I used to reorganize the books on top of the bookshelves. Nothing out of the ordinary here. Okay, so there's nothing. Oh, they're here. I don't know who killed Rentaro, but it's Monokuma's fault it happened. Because he pressured us, this happened. The motive he gave us is part of it. So that is that strange music. He played that music at such a high volume to make us feel sick and want to kill.
Okay.
It was awful. I thought I'd go crazy.
I can't believe it.
I bet someone felt pressured by that and killed Rentaro. It's all Monokuma's fault. Anyway, we had to stop the mastermind, so this is the last murder that ever happens here. We just have to. Okay, promotional video PMG. PGM.
Trashy skank!
Don't talk to me, crotch itch! I'm fucking busy! You continue ignoring us while she fiddled with a controller.
Huh?
What's that controller for?
Ah!
Da-da-da! It's a prawn! Wait, prawn? Prawn? I don't mean to butt in the conversation, but don't you mean drone?
Actually.
If it was a drone, it team up with the rest of the Gang Lion Alliance to destroy humanity. I have no idea what she's talking about.
Then,
wait a second. The controller is.
Now
you're getting it, Dick Cheese. She laughed obnoxiously and pointed her finger upward.
Ha!
Feast your eyes
on the latest creation from the gorgeous girl genius, Miluruma.
She is pretty gorgeous, and she is pretty genius.
It's a drone!
A drum?
I told you, that's a drone! If it was a drone, it'd be leading a pack of vicious monsters!
I don't get it.
When did you have time to make this?
I got bored after I made those cameras you asked for, so I modified this RC plane. I even decked it out with a camera so it'll take perfect aerial photographs.
Oh, nice!
From there, I'll use the photos as a reference to draft a floor plan to help the investigation. This way, I get out of having to do any actual investigative legwork.
I love her. I love her stupidness of this just weird-ass thing. Drafting a floor plan with photos? That's amazing. I'm sure this would help the investigation.
Out of my way!
The only problem is, I'm not used to operating a drone and taking pictures with it.
Jeez.
You shouldn't be proud of that. And if you don't hurry, the investigation will end soon.
Bitch!
I can't do that shit about that. So just calm your tiny tits and shut up.
Jeez.
Shut up? You! My chest is way better than your nasty cow udders. Oh my god! She can dish it out, but she cannot do vice versa.
What did I do?
Udders? Udders?
Actually,
you're a bit wimpy when someone stands up to you, huh? You're actually a complete wuss. I love her! No wonder my people fell in love with her. God dang. The moving bookcase is closed right now, so the hidden door is currently out of sight.
By the way,
you guys set up a security sensor on the top of this bookcase, right?
Okay.
Yeah, it should be still there. Let me check. Tsubishi climbed up the ladder and looked on top of the moving bookcase.
Remember,
it's still here. I should take it down now.
Oh.
Removing it is fine, but won't your receiver go off when you move it?
No.
No, it's alright. I turn the receiver off.
Mm-hmm.
You could turn it off.
Okay.
Yes, I made sure to switch it off on the way down here. I thought the mastermind could still be inside, and I didn't want to alert them.
I see.
And smart thinking. Okay, cool. Alright, who else do we need to talk to? Let's talk to Maid Girl.
But
why did the culprit not step forward and take advantage of the first blood perk?
Huh?
What?
Then
the culprit must have killed to survive. So it is odd that he would not step forward. True. I wonder what that means.
That's true.
I can think of several possibilities. But the worst case scenario is the culprit's objective wasn't to survive. It was to kill everyone here.
Huh?
Everyone?
That is correct.
That would explain why they would forego their survival in favor of a class trial. But doesn't that seem like a bit of a stretch to you?
Do you agree?
Well, if the culprit is also the mastermind, then it's certainly plausible.
Yeah.
Well, true. Healing us all does seem like something the mastermind would do.
Then,
so we cannot lose this fight, even on this uncharted path. We must find our way.
Okay then, I guess. Can we touch this? No, not really.
Here's the body. I'm pretty sure I don't need to tell you this, but shouldn't we investigate Rintaro's body? Yes, if we want to find clues, we have to. But if it's too much for you, Kaede, you don't have to, okay?
No.
No, it's fine. I can do it. My mind was set. I started to walk toward Rintaro's body. The last time I saw Rintaro, he was alive and well. Why did Rintaro die here?
Huh?
What do you mean, die here?
Remember.
I mean, if Rintaro was the one who moved the bookcase, that would mean he came all the way over here after the bookcase opened. He moved away from the hidden door to this spot. Why would he do that? And there's no trace of his body being moved. It doesn't add up.
Are you okay?
You've gone pale. Although, I guess that's normal. We have to investigate a body after all. The body of someone who was alive and talking to us just a little while ago.
No.
It's okay, really. We just have to do our best. Not just for Rintaro's sake, but also so we could avenge him. And so we could protect everyone else. We have to defeat the mastermind who's orchestrating this whole thing.
Hey!
Kaede? I'll help you any way I can. I'll support you in this investigation. I am sort of a detective, after all.
Jeez.
Sort of? You are a detective, remember?
Okay.
Alright. Okay, so what can we investigate that's here? Just the body? Really? Wow. We do not get a lot. A bloody shot put ball is on the ground.
Could it be
the shot put ball? Could it be?
Yeah.
Yeah, it definitely came from the warehouse on the first floor. There's blood all over it. It's the murder weapon, right? I don't see anything else that could have been used.
You're right.
The shot itself is heavy. It would have to be fairly strong to use it as a weapon. Fairly strong, huh? I mean,
you could literally just use this. Use the stair bookcase right here. And also this, look at that. There's a little opening. You could use that opening to hide yourself and then boop, smack down right to his thing. It would also explain the way this kind of like trips down. Yeah, that little bugger did it. Like the show did it. He probably wanted to save everybody instead. I know we need to examine this body, but I'm not sure where to start.
Leave it to me.
It's okay. I could do it. Sushi showed no hesitation as he began to examine the Rintaro's body. There's blood on the back of his head.
It looks like a pretty deep wound. It's consistent with blunt force trauma. I don't see any other injuries. The Monokuma file is accurate. This must be the fatal wound. So, we can trust the Monokuma file?
Okay.
Yes, for now. Suichi then stuck his hand into Rentaro's body.
Huh?
Oh, pocket. Wait, what are you doing? I'm checking what he has on his person. There might be a clue. If you're going to do this, we have to be thorough. I told you I would support you after all. How can you say that with such confidence? Come on, Kaede, pull yourself together. Rentaro had it in his possession, the key to his room, and a student handbook, a monopad. The monopad is definitely his. It's exactly the same model as ours. He didn't have a car key on him?
Could it be?
That's what I was thinking, but he didn't have it. Then Rentaro really wasn't the mastermind. If he was the mastermind, he wouldn't have come here with the car key. So, with what we know now, this is most likely a possibility. Why was Rentaro here if he wasn't the mastermind? He was probably trying to like beat up all Monokumas, like they were saying. And then he died.
Are you okay?
Kaede, are you okay? We're finished investigating the body. Let's go out of here for now.
Sorry.
Okay? Alright, so I think we need to investigate a few more things, though. Something is bothering me. Why did Rentaro come to the library? It seems likely that he's not the mastermind. What reason did he have to come here? I'm guessing it had something to do with what Rentaro mentioned earlier. It's not about outfoxing everyone in this killing game. It's about ending the game itself. That's the real goal. Ending the game itself?
Could it be?
Then it's possible. He noticed the hidden door in the library just like we did.
Huh?
What?
He
might have come to the same conclusion we did. That the mastermind would come here. You mean he had the same idea as us? No way. He should have told us. We could have worked together. I collapsed to the floor, crushed by the weight of my frustration.
No.
He probably couldn't risk telling us. Like you said, he was suspicious of everyone. I have you, Kaede. But Rentaro didn't have anyone else he could trust. That might have been the only difference between me and him. As he said that, he offered me a hand. I took his hand and he firmly pulled me up to my feet.
Remember,
Kaede, let's go. We can't waste time now. You're not going to give up, right? You're going to save everyone.
Yeah.
Suichi. He's right. I can't give up now.
Suichi.
Thanks. I feel like I could rely on you even more.
Huh?
Suichi is right. We can't give up until it's over. I can't stay depressed forever. I have to help everyone out, get out of here. We have to continue the investigation. We gotta find the mastermind.
Alright, what else do we have going on here? I think we've talked to everybody that we need to talk to.
It's a mysterious glow, but I don't think it was anything to do with the incident.
Nope. You're missing something. What are you missing? The rear sliding door? This is a rear door. It's the furthest door for the stairs and at least the hallway. By the way, this is a sliding door, see? It opens when you slide it.
Okay.
Yes, I saw that.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think Rentaro entered through this door?
I
can't say for sure until we get those pictures back from the Monocubs. You're right. We'll just have to wait.
Okay. Was that it? Really? I'm still missing something? What am I missing? I feel like I talked to everybody here. Did I go on this?
Tons of books are crammed in a bookcase and arranged in various stacks on top. It doesn't seem as if anything has changed since we set out the cameras.
Remember,
the books that you stacked up aren't moved.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean the ones I stacked to keep people from going through the vent? Yeah, those have been left alone. Okay, there we go. Stacked bookcases. We got it. Feel like I'm missing something. What? Really? Again still? What else are you missing? I feel like I've done all of it. Oh, you didn't hit the body. Yeah, I think we're done here. So maybe we just have to talk to, let's talk to Suichi. Hey, Kaede, do you remember what we saw when we came in here?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember.
You
saw the moving bookcase close on its own, right?
Hmm.
No one even touched it, so how did that happen?
Hmm.
Actually, it has to do with how the bookcase works. Suichi moved the bookcase to reveal the hidden door.
Is that all right?
Take a look at this. If I let go of the bookcase, you let go of the bookcase, and after waiting for a bit, it closed on its own.
Hmm.
The bookcase is set up like an automatic door. It closes after a period of time. It makes perfect sense when you think about it. If it didn't close on its own, you wouldn't be able to put the bookcase back after you went inside.
I see.
The bookcase has to close on its own once you go through the hidden door. Okay, there we go. But wait, if the bookcase closes itself after you enter the hidden door... maybe the reason why the bookcase closed itself was because the mastermind was hiding just past the hidden door.
You're right.
After killing Rentaro, they ran through the hidden door. It certainly is possible. Let's check that out now.
Huh?
How do we check it and check it out?
Remember.
The dust on the card reader, remember? So she moved the bookcase again to reveal the hidden door once more.
Then...
Alright, let's see. We lean in to get a closer look at the gape of the card reader. The dust is still there.
You're right.
It looks like the card reader wasn't used. That means the mastermind didn't hide. What if the mastermind replaced the dust after they used the card reader?
No.
No, I remember exactly where I put the dust. This hasn't been moved at all.
Okay.
I think it's safe to assume the mastermind did not go through this door. Then the one who moved the moving bookcase at the time was... Rentaro himself?
No.
I can't say for sure. We'll know more when we get to the pictures back. There's a chance that someone else was hiding there.
Mm-hmm. I see.
Well, I still think the mastermind is the culprit. So we just need to find the clues that can connect us to the mastermind. And we'll end the killing game that way too. Okay. Really? What else am I missing? Who else do I have to talk to? I feel like I've looked at everything. This thing? The time when it started the killing game had almost expired, but then the countdown stopped, and that obnoxious noise went away too. I wonder what would have happened if the time limit had expired. Hmm. I feel like I've done everything. I just need to talk to other people, I guess. Something. Can we talk to him again?
Be careful.
Yeah. He's just gonna say the same thing. Oh, can we look at this? Yep, we can. So let's look at the front door. It's the front door that leads directly to the basement stairs. We went through this door before we discovered Rentaro's body.
Hmm.
We entered the library through here with Kaido and Tenko.
Yeah.
We saw the moving bookcase close, And then when we ran over...
That's true.
We found Rintaro's body behind the bookcase. I wonder if Rintaro entered through the same door as we did. Maybe the mastermind did too.
That's...
When we see the pictures after the Monocubs developed them, that will be clear.
Aww.
I guess all we could do is wait. Kaede, I think we're investigating the entire library now. But we still don't know anything yet. I feel like we didn't get any closer to the mastermind.
You're right.
The more important piece of evidence will be those photos. Once we get those. Then again, we can't just say that and do nothing. Let's keep investigating what we can. Keep investigating.
That's true.
Yes. I think we should collect alibis. We need to verify where everyone was during the time frame where Rintaro was killed.
I see.
If that's the case, then who should we question?
Mm-hmm.
The six people that went down to the basement were Rintaro, Kaido, Gunta, Maki, Tenko, Angie, and Himiko. Let's talk to them first. They should have been in the game room along with Rintaro. Let's ask them about what happened there.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go find them. For now, let's head to the game room. Okay, cool. Alright, so I guess we'll talk to Tsuichi.
Then?
Over there, it's Maki. She was in the game room I saw in the... She was one of the people I saw in the game room. Let's ask her what she was doing. Okay, so, just hot tip, everybody? I think Maki's the one that's working with the Monokumas. I do think that's the case in point, and probably the reason why she's so standoffish is because like she doesn't want to develop feelings for anybody. And while we saw her first in the library, but I don't know for sure because, like I said before, complete blind play, have no idea. But that's my guess. Regardless, I still love her. Maki, you were in the game room when Rintaro was killed, right?
Hey.
What were you doing down here? Rintaro was with you, right?
Hey.
Am I a suspect? Oh no, that's not what I meant. You should suspect me. In fact, you should be suspicious of everyone.
Huh? Because...
Someone got killed right after we all gathered here. The timing is too perfect. Then again, the time went so close to expiring. I mean, that's why it happened.
You don't know?
So trust no one, Kaede. Or you'll lose. Got it? Can't get a read on Maki at all. She just saw a dead body, yet she's perfectly calm. It's hard to imagine her as the ultimate child caregiver.
But...
Why were you all here in the first place? It was Kaido's idea. He suddenly wanted to hold a strategy meeting and gather this all together. He said he would confront Monokuma once the time limit expires.
I don't understand.
They picked the seven people he thought would be useful in a fight. Seven people? Kaido, Gunta, Maki... Tenko, Himiko, Angie, and Rintaro? But, I'm not sure those seven would all be useful in a fight, though.
I see.
Kaito thought Himiko's magic and Angie's connection to Atua would be useful.
Huh?
What about you, Maki? Why did he also pick the ultimate child caregiver?
This is stupid.
He just looked at me and said, yeah, you probably know how to fight. That's it? Jeez. That does sound like something Kaido would do, though. But why have a strategy meeting in the game room in the basement?
I don't know.
Beats me. Maybe Kaido figured it out, but, it would be hard for Monokuma to find us here. In other words, it was just a coincidence? And what was Rintaro doing at the time? Was he in a strategy meeting with you?
That's true.
He was, at first. but then he excused himself to go to the bathroom and left on his own. Kaido and Tenko went looking for him so we could finish the meeting before time expired. That must have happened around... Huh? Oh, what are you guys doing? Well, never mind. Your time is perfect. You should join our strategy meeting. Kaede is definitely welcome to join. And did the four of you just wait in the game room the whole time?
Nope.
Angie, Himiko, and I are the ones who stayed behind. Gunta never joined us.
Huh?
Gunta wasn't with you guys? Gunta did arrive, but he left and locked himself in the AV room in the back. He was in the AV room by himself?
Ew.
Suspicious behavior, isn't it? The other two felt the same way. What other two?
Like I'd know.
Why don't you go to the AV room? They're probably still there. Okay, Maki's account. Oh, we're getting like the full thing.
Shuichi.
Full Monty. The AV room is that room in the back, right?
Could it be...
Kaede, have you ever been in there before?
Yeah.
Nope, not yet. Anyway, let's go. Oh, dang. This is weird.
Wait!
Gunta, not murder anyone!
Come on, man.
I told you, we're not saying you did. We just want to talk.
No.
No, it's him, all right. He's got the face of a killer.
No way!
No, just Gunta by his outside. An innocent Gunta gentleman.
Hey.
Hey, what's going on here?
Ah.
Oh, hey there, Kaede. We're just trying to ask him. And just tell us why we're still asking nicely. Are you or are you not the culprit?
Yeah.
Or are you not the culprit? Are you not the culprit?
Huh?
Gunta, not. It's just been this over and over. We can't move forward at all. I think your questions are the problem.
Hmm.
Then I'll change the question. Timmy buys 5 strawberries for 50 cents each. And 1 apple.
Jeez.
That's totally off topic, Himiko. Do your math homework on your own.
You know?
Hey, Gunta. I talked to Maki earlier. You were in the basement AV room alone. The whole time, right? But why were you... What were you doing here alone? Gunta happy to be invited to meeting. But Gunta think he not be much help. Cause he not smart.
Bugs are...
So Gunta here alone watching bug movie.
Huh?
What? How does that help?
Honest.
Bug movie fill Gunta with fight. Make Gunta fight. Ready to fight Monokuma.
I see.
So, it helps you fight? Okay, sure. You do you, Gunta. Gunta's a good boy.
But you know.
But why was it locked?
Huh?
What was locked?
With my magic.
You don't answer honestly. I'll change you into a girl with my magic.
Huh?
Gunta, no can become girl Gunta, then Gunta will never become gentleman.
Jeez.
Himiko, can you just shut up for a second? You're making this harder than it needs to be.
Is that alright?
Gunta, can you tell us what happened next?
Gunta.
Just needs focus. If Gunta no focus, Gunta no can fill up with fight. Oh, god dang it.
Honest.
That it? Really? Gunta just want to protect everyone. But you guys not believe Gunta, huh? Cause Gunta's so big and scary looking, huh?
Wow!
Calm down! You're making a real scary face!
How can this be?
Cause Gunta feels so useless! Poor Gunta. After hearing his story, I could see why people would suspect him. I wonder what really happened. Could he actually be the mastermind? I don't believe for a second. Gunta's a good boy. He's a gentleman. Kaede, let's investigate this room a little more. We also need to verify Gunta's alibi.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. Alright, trying to see if I can find anything in particular. And by that, I mean Monokuma stuff. There's this. This door is different than the one we used to enter the game room. Is this connected to the hallway?
You're right.
It seems that way. Oh, let's check.
Yeah.
It's a sliding door. I'll open it. I tried to open it, but...
Huh?
That's weird. It doesn't open all the way. Looks like it wasn't installed right. I can only stick my arm through. I can see the hallway on the other side, but I suppose it's not possible to use this door.
No.
If it's Gunta, it doesn't matter if the door was stuck. He's strong enough to throw the super heavy manhole cover.
That's right.
Yeah, he could eat this door for breakfast.
Gunta never do that!
Gunta not eat door for breakfast? Breakfast, most important meal of any gentleman's day.
Okay.
I agree.
Huh?
Huh? You think Gunta could eat this door?
No.
Not that. I mean, I don't think he did anything like that. Look at this.
Is that alright?
There's dust piled up on the railing on the door. This sliding door hasn't moved in a while. So then, he just forced his way through the gap? That's not possible. There's maybe enough space for a baseball to fit through. I guess an arm could fit through as well, if it were thin enough.
It's magic.
So then, you probably use magic to make you slip and keeps the fat off.
Wait!
Good to know you use magic!
Okay!
Oh, I could use magic. These two never seem never have anything important to say. No, they don't.
What's the matter?
What's the matter, Suichi?
No.
Nothing. Just something I want to confirm. I'm gonna try the sliding door one more time. As Suichi peeked through the gap in the sliding door, he muttered,
I knew it.
I thought so. Look, you can see the rear entrance in the library from here. This door and the rear entrance are located straight across from one another. So what?
That's...
I'm not sure if it matters yet, but it is a little concerning. Concerning how? Christ, sliding door has been put to the test. I think we investigated everything here, too.
Mm-hmm.
Then what should we do next?
Hey!
For now, let's ask the others some questions. There's still people we haven't talked to.
Aww.
This would be done if we have the pictures. We won't have to waste our time like this. I already know who the mastermind is. That's true. We shouldn't wait around and do nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. What, we're just not gonna ask people at all? Let's look at the poster bucket. There's some posters rolled up in the rubber bands in the little bucket. Is this a movie poster? They're all the same, though. I took the poster out and rolled it. Ultra Despair Girls 2, coming soon? It looks like a game, but I never heard of it before. A high school girl with a megaphone and a serial killer? Sounds like some lame spinoff. Is this one of Monokuma's pranks?
Yeah.
Probably. Dang, they just had to like do that little jab, didn't they? A lot of movies cramped in the bookcase. Oh, The Legend of 1900! I've always wanted to see this film.
That's...
The one with the pianist that has eyes like a dead fish, right?
Huh?
This film won for its phenomenal music. U.S. audiences were moved to tears.
Really?
Well, Americans do tend to get emotional. Hey, you take that back, you punk!
Huh?
What else do they have here? I grabbed a movie at random. And the case was covered with pictures of naked men and women. Find any other movies over there? No, nothing suspicious at all over here. Let's go look somewhere else.
What happened?
What's wrong? Did you see something?
That's wrong.
I said it's nothing. There's nothing here but a bunch of movies. Movies.
Wait.
Kaede, you're panicking. It's okay if you found a clue. You can tell me. Here, let me look.
Jeez.
No, don't come over here. A couple minutes later, we were both looking down the floor with beet red faces. Well, that did not end well.
Right?
I told you.
Sorry.
Let's investigate somewhere else. Okay. Look here too. Let's just forget this happened and move on. Okay, so it's just both dialogues either way. I bet this new speaker produces some high quality music, but it's not relevant now. Alright, so let's talk to Kaido.
Damn.
Jeez, I can't believe that happened right next door to our strategy meeting.
Hey.
Kaido, can you tell me more about the strategy meeting of yours? You gathered everyone to meet in the basement, right?
Huh?
What? Am I one of the suspects now?
No,
that's not what I'm...
Nah.
Nah, it's natural that you're suspicious of me.
Of course!
But I'm not the culprit, I swear it on the universe!
Got it.
I got nothing to hide. So you could ask, be anything.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then?
Well, now that we have the chance, let's look back on the entire incident together. Kaido went to the scene with us, so he might have noticed something we missed.
Got it.
Alright then, where should we start?
Hmm.
After Kaede and I set up the cameras, we were keeping watch from the classroom. Some time passed and then we saw you guys go down the basement.
Hey!
Where did you start asking people to go with you?
So...
I don't remember the exact time, but I asked them one by one. We all went there together.
Okay.
That's when we saw you. You, Kunta, Maki, Tenko, Angie, Yumiko, and Rintaro.
You know...
Now I think about it, the monitor started going off just before then. The creepy music made it hard to keep the strategy meeting going. I want to confirm what you've just told me so far. Everyone went to the game room for this meeting and no one went to the library, right?
Ah.
Yeah, we went straight to the game room. And right after we went inside, Kunta went into the AV room and wouldn't come out.
Yeah.
Yeah, Maki told me about that.
So...
After that, during the meeting, Rintaro left to go to the bathroom. We thought it'd be bad if the meeting stopped, so me and Tenko went to get him back. And that's when we met up with you guys.
Okay.
We had gone to the basement because the security sensor receiver went off.
Yeah.
And right, when I was about to open the library door, you guys called out to us. So after you and Tenko left the game room, Himiko and Maki were still there, right?
Got it.
Yeah, I guarantee that.
But you know...
However, I can't guarantee that Kunta was in here the whole time.
I see.
So we can't confirm Kunta's alibi yet.
Hey!
The library's rear entrance is at the end of the hallway, correct? Did you see anyone there?
That's right.
Well, I didn't get a good look, but I'm sure I would have noticed someone was there.
Jeez.
Then I opened the door to the library with you guys and found Rintaro's dead body. That's just how it all went. We didn't learn any new information, though.
Come on, man.
So I'm not clear to suspicion yet? Huh?
No.
Ah, don't worry. You're not a likely suspect.
Dumbass.
Hey, that's something a detective would say. What?
Listen up.
Suspect me, you better pursue it to the end. Investigate until you're satisfied. If you don't do that, you'll never reach the truth. Rintaro would have died for no other reason.
Got it.
This is where you need to let your ultimate talent shine. Suichi?
Yeah.
Anyway, if you notice something or remember anything, let us know.
Of course.
Well, I'm planning on leaving it all to you guys. I'll investigate my own way. Okay. What about you, Himiko? The culprit is definitely Kunta. He's suspicious no matter how you look at it.
No.
No, it's still too early to determine that. There are a lot of things to consider. Really? Even so, it's definitely Kunta. He's suspicious no matter how you look at it. No? Why don't you help investigate before you decide that, Himiko?
What a pain.
Investigating is a pain. Kunta's suspicious, no matter how you look at it.
Got it?
Like I said, you need to investigate before you decide that. Hell, use your magic for all I care.
It's impossible.
Magic shouldn't be used for that. It'll lead to corruption.
Jeez.
Then stop being so lazy and put some actual effort into solving this. She's a lazy bone, that's all she is.
Gonta.
Watching bug movie. To fill Gunta with fight, so Gunta could fight Montaguma. But Gunta need focus to fill up with fight, so Gunta locked door. That sounds like a lie. You don't tell the truth, I'll blow your clothes off with magic.
Huh?
If Gunta naked in public, then Gunta never become gentleman.
Jeez.
Hayumiko, shut up! Stop saying ridiculous things.
Honest.
Gunta just wants to protect everyone. Really?
Why?
Why no one believe Gunta? Gunta feels so pathetic. Poor Gunta.
Yeah, I think we're done here. Whew. Then we'll leave here. Already did Maki's thing. So where to now? I guess we just have to see other people. Wait, what the? Oh, that is weird. There's a light going on here. Isn't it supposed to be like nighttime? Alright, whatever.
Hey.
You're not going to investigate Angie? Investigating is important, but I gotta say my prayers to Atua through.
Amen.
Oh, Atua, please let Rintaro enter heaven safe and sound.
Hey.
I suppose a prayer could hurt. Rintaro died in such a gruesome way. Would he be able to go to heaven in peace? It'd be nice if he could.
It'll be okay.
Don't worry, I'll pray hard. If I pray hard enough, I'll earn enough points to become a platinum disciple.
Huh?
Sounds like a credit card rewards program. Hey, if you gotta do what you gotta do. And that's what you gotta do. Tenko, I wanted to ask you something. We asked Tenko about what happened in the game room, but she only confirmed what Maki had told us and didn't provide any new information. Oh dang, they just skipped her entirely.
Mm-hmm.
I see.
That's right!
I knew it! Gunta would be the most suspicious since he locked himself in the AV room. Not to mention he's also a male. Are you submitting that as evidence?
Hey.
By the way, how has your investigation been going?
No.
I haven't done any investigating.
Huh?
What?
Degenerate male!
Hey, degenerate! Don't give me that face! I've been doing something else. I've been watching Angie.
Huh?
Watching Angie?
Listen up!
We agreed to investigate with one other person, right? But Angie's just been wandering around alone.
I see.
Oh, that's why you're with Angie. I don't want to suspect anyone either, but girls' lives are at stake here.
Okay.
For an investigation like this to work, we have to trust each other. Oh, she doesn't look too happy right now.
Degenerate male!
Don't act all high and mighty with me, you two-faced degenerate!
No.
Sorry, that wasn't my intention.
I agree with her. All the males are out to get us. Every single one.
Okay, do I go to the classroom now or what? God dang.
So, oh, yeah, there's three people here. Oh no, there's two people.
Kaede, Suichi, I would like to ask you two a question. You were on lookout inside this classroom, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, from here, we could keep an eye on the basement and it was close to the library too.
You're right.
That's our alibi. We were both in the classroom when the murder occurred.
I see.
Then the probability that you two committed the crime is extremely low. By the way, were you two together the entire time?
No.
I did leave for a bit to see what was happening in the basement. But besides that, we were together the whole time. Until the receiver went off.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Thank you very much.
I understand. Thank you very much.
Okay, lookout classroom.
Hey.
Is that all you wanted to ask? May I ask you one more question? Specifically about the vent.
By the way,
it appears we can enter this classroom. The air duct to the basement hallway leads it.
That's...
Yes, I was also concerned about this vent. That's why we kept watching this classroom.
That's right.
because the culprit wouldn't be able to use this vent if we're in here on lookout.
That's right.
Under those circumstances, it would be difficult to sneak into the library from here.
Okay.
Kaede stacked up books in front of the library vent as well. With those in the way, it would be even harder for someone to go in and out.
I'll commit that to my memory bank.
Really? I'll be sure to save that important piece of information to my memory bank.
Thank you very much.
I hope my line of questioning has not offended either of you. It is necessary, and so that you may find the truth. Kipo, you totally sound like a detective or a lawyer right now. Maybe you were a detective or a lawyer in a past life. A past life. How could I have a past life when I'm not made of human components? Past programming? Let me guess. You wish to hear my alibi, yes? How do you know?
You see,
my appearance and actions thus far suggest I am someone who would commit murder. At least he's self-aware.
Well,
so to briefly state the truth, when the body discovery announcement played, I was in the dining hall eating supper.
Ah, yes.
The other people that were with me were Miu, Kurumi, and Sugumi. The monocons prepared the meal for me. It was listed on the menu as pastas that taste like a lonely old lady eating her grandkids' birthday cake, or some such. That pasta sounds depressing.
Do you understand?
That concludes my alibi. I do hope it could be of some help.
Hey!
And what about the people around you? Do you notice anything in particular?
Yes.
If there was something to note, it would be that Mew was tinkering with something or other. There was also a brief period of time where Sumugi left to go use the bathroom. The restroom, huh? Interesting. Well, Sumugi is the ultimate cosplayer. She could have gone to the bathroom to secretly disguise herself as someone else. Someone else? But who?
Yeah.
I don't know, but I'll go talk to her. She should be at the crime scene in the library. Okay. So I got her account. Or rather, his account, and then... Can't leave yet, eh? It's dusk already. You ate what? You aren't bored, are you? So what is the other thing I have to investigate? The door? I guess door. Asks to what they were doing during the body discovery announcement. What? Oh, okay. Ah, god dang it. I have to ask him too. It was because he was asking me, that's why I was confused.
Hey.
Hey, Kibo, what were you doing and where during the body discovery announcement? My alibi.
Huh?
Are you glitching right now?
Well.
No, I am searching for the right words. In all honesty, I was alone in my room, so I admit my alibi is not altogether reliable. So you don't have an alibi? But Romeo said he was alone in his room too.
Aww.
Jeez, way to throw him under the bus.
Huh?
That was not my intention. But I see. But Kibo and Roima don't have an alibi. Roima is the killer. Come on. That means it's possible one of those two is the mastermind. That does not mean that, though. Am I under suspicion because I don't have an alibi?
No.
No, I won't suspect you just because you don't have an alibi.
Of course.
But I'm not saying that because you're a robot or anything. I'm not robophobic, after all.
Thank you very much.
But you don't need to be so, PC. Okay, here's his account.
Okay.
Putting aside the thing about Sumugi, now I know everyone's alibi.
Huh?
What about Kokichi?
No.
We don't need to ask him. He was definitely alone. Everyone we talked to hasn't seen him. So no one could corroborate his alibi, right? That means he must have been alone.
I see.
Oh, you're right. I guess that's why you're the detective and I'm not. Okay, so we only have one more alibi to go by, and that's Sumiki's. Sumiki's. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. This should go do it. And then I think we'll be done. Let's go on back. Let's head on back and see what the cosplayer's doing. Boop, 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 boop. Yeah, I was going to.
Hey.
Sumugi, I need to ask you something. She looks like she's busy thinking about something. She won't talk to me. Okay, but there's no excuse to give up. I grab the hem of Sumugi's skirt and begin to lift it slowly.
Got it?
I'm gonna lift your skirt, Sumugi. You okay with that? Wait, Kaede. You better talk or I'm gonna lift your skirt for Fuichi to see. And then I'm gonna tie your skirt around you, your head so everyone can see your panties.
I understand.
I just need to talk, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, took you long enough.
Oh.
Well, I can't let Suichi's innocent eyes get dirty.
That's wrong.
No, they won't get dirty.
Suichi.
Are you saying you've seen dirtier, Suichi?
What's wrong?
What do you want to talk about?
You know?
I'm just gonna cut to the chase. Since you're the ultimate cosplayer, that means you can disguise yourself as anyone, even one of us, right? So that's what you think of me. Well, since we're in this situation, I'll be clear.
That's impossible!
I only cosplay fictional characters. I don't cosplay real people. Or rather, I can't. You can't? Isn't it easy just to wear someone else's clothes as a disguise and...
You can't!
Cosplay isn't a disguise!
Huh?
Sorry!
I guess.
Well, you'll probably have a hard time believing me if I just say it, so I'll show you. Show me how.
Come here.
Come on, Kaede. Wait. Oh, where are we going off to? Sumugi grabbed my hand and dragged me to the girls' bathroom on the first floor. Are you gonna punch me or tie me up?
Hey now.
There's no way I'd do things like that.
Hey.
Now hurry up and take your clothes off.
Huh?
Why? Well, because I'm going to cosplay as you, of course. Now, give me your clothes.
Huh?
Why?
Right?
Oh, come on, hurry up.
Huh?
What? I slowly undressed and handed my clothes to Sumugi. After telling her to look the other way, I waited while she changed into my clothing.
Yeah.
Okay, now I can look.
Huh?
Whoa! A gross bumpy rash had spread across Sumugi's body.
Hi, I'm Kaede Akamatsu. This isn't cosplay of the spiky-headed underling of a certain space emperor. This is Cospox, an allergic reaction that happens when I dress up as real people.
Okay, then.
This is the price for my power. The equivalent exchange for my cosplay.
Oh my god.
Okay, I get it. Change out of my clothes already.
We exchanged our clothes and returned to the library, where Suichi was waiting.
What happened?
Kaede, what's wrong? Assume what you couldn't have disguised yourself?
Yeah.
You understand since you saw the Cospox, right? Cosplay is love.
You're right!
You breathe life into characters. It's almost like you're summoning them. From fiction into the real world, like an oracle channeling the gods. That's why I could cosplay various characters from across the wide world of fiction. It's impossible to cosplay as someone who exists in the real world.
Right?
Because it's not cosplay. It's just impersonating somebody. I really don't need that long explanation. Oh god, here it go.
Huh?
This chime!
You bastards!
It's time, you bastards. Time for the long-awaited class trial.
Not that!
No, it's not. We're just announced the photos are ready. Don't interrupt me. Anyway, I'll be waiting at the warehouse. Hey, does my face look weird to you? Does my face always look this weird?
So long, farewell.
Weird.
Hey.
Did you hear that, Suichi? Pictures have finally been developed. Let's go, come on. Get a move on. Oh wait, Kaede. I ran as fast as I could to the school warehouse. I couldn't stay put, knowing that the truth was so close at hand. I ran a full sprint to the warehouse.
Wait!
Kaede, you shouldn't get so worked up.
Please.
I can't help it. We're so close to learning the truth. We're gonna find out who the mastermind is.
Rise and shine, Ursine!
Oh, you came!
We're intruding!
Sure did. I came to see you, Tuts. You're as lovely as always. Oh, Monosuke, you're such a flirt. Oh, may I join you for a drink?
What are you saying?
Drink as much as you want. I got cash to bear.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Excuse me, can we get a bottle here? This is great.
Oh, jeez.
Hey, how long are you guys gonna do this for? Take these. It's all the photos. They're separated in envelopes for each camera. Use them to take the masters down. It's all up to you now.
Dumbass!
I'm so rich, what's a journalist not gonna do about it? Nothing, that's what. By the way, Monofi, wanna get out of here after your shift ends?
Woo-hoo!
I want a fancy steak dinner. What's your name and age? Home district? Salary? Do you have another job?
So long, farewell!
Freaking, what is this mess? Anyway, it looks like we have the pictures now.
Yeah.
Finally. Oh god, they're all here. Kaede, are those the developed photos?
Right?
The culprit should be in those photos, right?
Hehehe.
How exciting. I want to see the dumb look on the culprit's face.
All right.
Oh, let's take a look.
Let's
look at the photos taken by the camera near the front entrance first. The envelope says front entrance has a total of 4 pictures. Let's see the first picture. Oh, darn. This is when we arrived at the library. So I took a picture then.
Ah.
Yeah, this was right before we found, Rintaro's body. And that's a pretty bad picture of me. But don't focus on it too much, okay?
But of course.
Rest assured, we do not care.
Hmm.
Alright, let's go to the next one.
Is this...
It's a picture of us running into the library after we heard Tanaka scream. That doesn't help us at all. Hurry up and show us the next picture.
Yeah.
Okay.
It seems as if...
This is everyone else who came to the library after the body discovery announcement.
Yeah.
Everyone pictured here, myself included, was on our way to the basement. So we got there a bit late.
You know...
Hey... they're all pictures of when we found the body. There's one more photo of the front entrance, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's take a look at that one.
Huh?
Suichi?
Ah.
Sorry, it looks like I tripped one of the camera sensors when I was removing the cameras.
Yeah.
What are you saying?
This
picture doesn't seem to have any clues that would help us either. The camera pointed at the front entrance only snapped these 4 pictures. Neither Rintaro nor anyone else could be the culprit in the photos.
Hey.
Did they both enter through the back door then?
That is correct.
Let's examine the photos taken by the camera near the rear entrance then.
Yeah.
Only 2 photos were taken by the camera point at the rear entrance. So let's see the first picture. Rintaro!
I knew it.
So Rentaro went through the rear entrance. Perhaps so no one would see him.
I see.
I thought it might be possible that he was moved in the library after being murdered. That does not appear to be the case.
If so...
So that means he was killed in the library. After going through his... of his own will.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's move on to the next one. Maybe they'll show the mastermind.
Huh?
Sorry.
Me again. This is from when I was removing the camera. What an attention hog.
No.
I had no choice. He had no choice to remove their cameras. He had to be close to the sensors. That's all for the rear entrance. Just these two photos.
Huh?
Culprit not the rear entrance photo either.
Why?
What does this mean? They're not in either the front or rear entrance pictures. Yeah, that's pretty odd. Why isn't there a picture of the mastermind entering them?
Hey.
Hey, Suichi, don't you think that's weird?
Let's
look at the picture from the hidden door camera. That might tell us something.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah! The camera should have captured the moment the mastermind opened the door. I opened what was the case as I removed the photos from the envelope. There were two photos. The first one was... Rentaru?
Hmm.
But if Rentaru was the one who moved the bookcase, then...
Oh.
He must have known about the hidden door!
Could it be...
Could the culprit have been, gone into the hidden door?
I see.
Yes, that is a possibility.
Do you understand?
But now, let us see the next picture. There's one remaining, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah, there is.
Huh?
What? Huh? What's Rentaro doing?
Yeah.
It looks like he's reacting to the camera. Maybe he was trying to remove it.
Ah.
I did notice something while I was removing the camera. The security sensor for this camera was switched off.
If so...
Who's this one? In that case, this photo was likely taken just before the sensor was turned off.
Hmm.
So that wouldn't mean that Rentaro noticed it. He saw our hidden camera?
By the way...
Moving the bookcase triggers the sensors, which in turn activates the camera, right? The bookcase appears to have already been moved. So why did the sensor activate?
I don't get it!
Who cares? What happened to the culprit? How come they're not in any of the photos?
It seems as if...
The last photo must have been taken shortly before Rentaro was killed.
However...
If so, then the culprit would be pictured right behind him in this photo. Then why is the culprit nowhere to be seen? That's all the photos. So we gained no clues, and we still don't know who the culprit is. What a fucking waste!
Why?
Did she really develop all the photos? Maybe she got rid of the ones that show the culprit. How rude! I developed all the film I was given. I swear by my almighty dad that I didn't.
You bastards!
Those are all the photos from the hidden cameras. So relax and get to deducing.
Don't screw around.
These are seriously all the pictures? You gotta be kidding me. The culprit's not in any of them. The culprit didn't go in the library. Then how they kill Rentaru? So this must be what they call a perfect crime?
Huh?
A perfect crime?
I'm disappointed.
Aw, man. I've already been slacking off because I thought these photos would reveal the culprit.
No.
You should have been helping us investigate.
By the way.
Rentaro had his, monopod the whole time, didn't he? Do you think anything, was in it?
I do not agree.
His student handbook did not contain much in the way of pertinent information.
Well,
I doubt it has anything to do with the case. He simply had his monopad with him.
Okay.
I inspected his monopad, but I didn't find anything suspicious about it.
Oh, man.
So it's got nothing to do with the case? How confusing.
Are you okay?
Kaede, are you okay? Why? Why aren't there any in the pictures? If Messerman had these photos, it would have solved everything. So why the hell? Kaede.
All right. It's time for what you've all been waiting for. The class trial. Please assemble in front of the Shrine of Judgment in the courtyard. Remember that red door surrounded by plants? It's just on the other side. From there, you'll be escorted to a delightful class trial. See you all there.
Huh? Time already?
That is correct.
It seems we have no choice but to continue this discussion at the class trial. I don't want to go.
What a pain.
Me neither. What a pain. What, you scared? Embassy like you has nothing to be scared of.
No.
It'll be fine. I just feel like my back is up against the wall.
Yeah.
We just need to expose the mastermind in this class trial.
Yeah, that's right.
And then everything, including this killing game, will come to an end.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
Got it.
Let's find this mastermind, and if it's a man, let's beat him to death.
Jeez.
Isn't beating them to death going a bit too far? Everyone followed Monokuma's instructions and walked toward the courtyard.
Are you okay?
Kaede, really, are you okay?
Sorry.
I didn't mean to worry you. I'm just so shocked. I really thought that everything would be resolved once we looked at the photos. But I can't give up. I still exposed the mastermind in this class trial. And then everything, even this killing game, will come to an end.
Yeah.
I'm okay now, Suichi.
Right?
Let's go. It's the red door in the courtyard, right? Okay. Okay. I think we're all good. We're almost all completely set. God dang. That was a lot. A lot. So I gotta go all the way to the Room of Judgment just to figure out what the heck's going on here. And then I think that'll be it, honestly. And then we'll start the class trial. It's this red door, right?
Hey!
Kaede, I have one more question.
Hmm.
Do you really think it's one of us? Not just the culprit? But the mastermind as well?
Huh?
Isn't that what you told me, Suichi?
Okay.
Yes, but it's just, this was only my deduction. I don't know if I should trust that.
Hmm.
Well, I don't know if it's true either, but that's why we need to confirm it. If you just dismiss a possibility, I'll look the other way without confirming anything.
Yeah.
Then you're just turning your back on the truth.
What's the matter?
Suichi, you seem so sure of yourself during the investigation.
Sorry.
Let's go. I'm sure they're waiting for us inside. Blah. They're all here.
What?
So this is the Shrine of Judgment?
Everyone!
Careful, everyone. If bad things happen, get behind Gunta.
Yoo-hoo!
Then give me a piggyback ride.
Yoo-hoo!
Come on, carry me!
Bitch!
Oh my god, you're so fucking annoying. So, are we doing the class trial here or what?
No.
No, Monokuma made it sound like we'd be guided somewhere from here.
That is troubling.
But Monokuma is nowhere to be seen. What's going on? Alright.
going to do his best.
Let's work together and get out here.
It's fine.
Don't worry about my cost box. It always goes away as soon as I stop trying to cosplay real people. Oh, I wonder, if I still have a cost box, can I get a note and be excused from the class trial? No, I guess it's out of the question.
Leave it to me.
Don't worry. If you gotta do a class trial or whatever, I'll do something about it.
Hey.
You better get ready. There's nowhere for us to run. Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
I'm sorry for what I said before. This is important, and I...
Wow.
It's finally happening! I can't wait to see what's in store for us!
Hey!
Where the hell are you gonna guide us? There's nowhere else to go. Get your jacked up-looking face out of my sight, you goddamn runt!
How terrifying.
Those who will be judged and those who will cast judgments. They are two sides of one coin. I wonder what awaits us on the other side of this fog of deception.
What are you trying to pull?
Those photos were a bust, so how are we supposed to find the culprit now? I don't know.
But...
Intriguing air surrounds that Monokuma statue. It's annoying to me. To no end.
Then...
If Monokuma's not gonna show up, then can we just go back?
Unfortunately...
I'm sorry, I can't even posit a question as to who the culprit might be.
But
I've given up. But I haven't given up. I assure you, we will avenge Ataru.
Sneak attack!
My determination is maximum. I will avenge Rentaru. That Monokuma statue is absurd!
Because Atua says so.
Even Atua agrees. He says it would be replaced with a more divine statue.
Alright, you heard everybody. We gotta look at the Monokuma statue.
The Monokuma statue gives off such a weird vibe.
Huh?
Wait, what? Well then. Well.
Huh?
Is this an elevator?
This is...
Does he want us to board it?
I don't wanna.
I don't do scary rides. I don't wanna go on it either. Stay behind then. Though I'm sure that'll be just, be worse for you in the end.
I guess...
Yeah, that's true. I know.
If you desire.
However, everyone wishes to run away. I will cooperate as well.
No.
That's probably not a good idea. There's nowhere to run. As long as the end wall exists, escape's not an option.
Hey.
It'll be fine. Let's all work together. Remember our promise. We're gonna escape this place and remain good friends after all.
I'll get us out of here.
So let's do it. I'm sure we'll be all right.
Mm-hmm.
Because we made such an incredible team. I wouldn't be able to call myself a man if I was still scared after hearing a girl say that. Bring it! I'll show them how I, Kaito Omoto, a luminary of the stars, live! Don't you mean die?
Dumbass.
Don't say something so ominous like that.
I'm ready!
We got all this far already. We gotta do it, so let's do it.
Okay.
We had no choice. We can't turn back now. Okay. Determined, we all stepped forward. Even as we walked toward the elevator, I was shaking with anxious dread. But I kept going, because I decided to fight. Then everyone had boarded the elevator.
That's super cool. It's actually an elevator.
Even so, this elevator is going pretty far down.
We're falling. I wonder how far we will plummet.
I suddenly have to go to the bathroom real bad.
By all means, go ahead.
Of course. A robot wouldn't understand how inappropriate that is.
As we waited to reach our destination, I whispered to Shuichi.
Shuichi? About that talk from before.
What?
I think everyone is afraid of learning the truth. But the people who are willing to find the truth are the ones who can decide their fate. If you never know the lies from the truth, then you can't choose a path. You won't even know you're on a path. So, fight for the truth. Even if it is frightening. I know you can do this. If you're scared, borrow the strength of others who will be there to help you. Think of everyone you're helping, and let that be your strength. I used to be like you. Before a piano concert, I was always so nervous that I thought I would vomit. But then I would remember all the people I've made smile with my performances.
Kaede.
All right, let's go. It's better to end bad stuff like this as soon as possible.
Those words were mainly for me, to inspire me, so I would not turn back. After some time, the elevator finally came to a halt. The door slowly opened to reveal what awaited us on the other side.
Why, hello, Bear!
Welcome to the class trial! Oh boy, the class trial is finally starting! Finally a game that actually feels like a game!
Bingo!
Just as the prophecy foretold!
Got it?
Listen up, from here on, things are gonna get so violent you'll wish you could turn back.
No way!
That's not true. There won't be any gore violent scenes, I'm positive.
This is...
authentic replica of a courtroom. What a bad taste.
Oh, jeez!
Why are you making us do this? Is this fun for you? Of course! Putting strangers in life or death scenarios is the best entertainment!
You're the worst of the worst!
You are seriously the worst! Worse or not, those who have fun are the real winners in this world. It doesn't matter what terrible things you do or are done to you, as long as you're having fun.
Oh, I see.
Wow, this is so sickening, it's almost refreshing. So, how do we get this game going?
Well, now.
There are podiums over there. Please stand behind the one with your name on it. Following Monokuma's instructions, we headed into our respective podiums. As I walked toward my podium, an image of his body flashed in my mind. Rintaro. He died without knowing his own ultimate talent. No. He was murdered by some horrible lowlife scumbag. I'll never forgive his killer. That's why we're going to expose the mastermind and the killing game. That's all I could do for Rintaro now. His killer is in the room with us. The mastermind is controlling Monokuma and forcing us to play this killing game. I don't think I'll ever be fully prepared to find out who that person is. We have to find out who it is so we can lift our suspicions of each other. So we can end this killing game. That's why I'm here. I can't show any fear yet. I must fight to the bitter end. We'll face this life or death class trial. Oh! God dang! A little longer than I expected to be, but we're finally here, folks. We're finally at the pinnacle of the save points. So that means go grab yourself popcorn, get yourself a nice little relaxing, time in the bathroom or whatever else, because I will be back for more Danganronpa tomorrow or whenever the heck you decide to watch the rest of the videos or whatever. But yeah, we're gonna save that for next time for the class trial, or I guess two parts of class trial if it's anything like Danganronpa 2. Regardless, thank you all for watching. It's a pleasure having you around. Thank you, DOS, for coming on in. Thank you, Ouija Power, for coming in as well. And anybody else that showed up, thank you all so much. It's a pleasure having you around. Till then, though, sayonara. Bye-bye.